Welcome back. We have breaking news into the newsroom. The Olympics Committee coming out and saying that they are now officially postponing the Olympics. We talked about this earlier in the show, and USA Today in an exclusive interview saying that they have made the decision to postpone the Olympics, likely to 2021. The details should be worked out in the next 4 weeks, but like we said earlier in the show, we know countries like Canada and Australia have already said that their athletes cannot compete amidst this pandemic.
Right. So after those two countries did that, the Olympic Committee decided we'll just go ahead and cancel.
Absolutely. And that was just from USA Today. So we will have all the latest information. Make sure to stay with us throughout the day and obviously KSAT.com.
If you ever wanted to learn how to play the guitar, now is your chance. So many people are staying at home. Now the guitar company's online school, Fender, offering 3 months of free lessons. You can learn to play guitar, bass, or the ukulele, but you need to sign up on the Fender website, and it's limited to the first 100,000 people.
And in the wake of the COVID-19 outbreak, musicians continuing to perform for audience, but thinking outside the box.
CNN's Rick Damigella looks at the emerging world of coronavirus concerts in today's Music Monday segment.
Hi, my name is Chris. Is this on?
As the world hunkers down amid the COVID-19 pandemic, musicians are getting in tune and continue to entertain us. The Berlin Philharmonic went on with the show recently, performing to an empty auditorium and making its archive of performances free for the next month. The Dropkick Murphys weren't about to let the coronavirus stop their annual St. Patrick's Day celebration. The boys from Boston still performed via live stream. The show is available on YouTube in case you missed it.
Because I missed singing for you guys, of course, is nowhere to go, because don't we all feel that way?
Melissa Etheridge is taking the online concert idea even further with daily performances she's calling the Stay at Home Concert Series. No tickets required, just head over to her Facebook page.
I hope all y'all got your rubber gloves and surgical masks on.
From a polar opposite genre, hardcore punk band Cro-Mags streamed and recorded a free concert for its fans just days after a planned performance at New York City's Webster Hall was canceled.
In the darkness, I feel holy.
And some artists are performing online to help others in need. Singer-songwriter Lily Kershaw joined a trio of other artists on YouTube to raise funds for Feeding America's COVID-19 Response Fund.
I know a place down past an old shack.
With more and more musicians announcing live stream performances, this could be how we enjoy live music for the time being. Pushing my streaming capability to the limit in Hollywood, I'm Rick Damigella.
And today, SA Live moving from Market Square into the KSAT studio.
That's right. Fiona and David are bringing the fun to home base. Hey, guys.
We are bringing a smile to your face today by celebrating National Puppy Day.
We're teaching your old dog some new tricks that'll up their brain game and fill you in on how you can help out some local rescues.
We're also sweetening your day with a mouth-watering cinnamon roll pancake recipe from Whiskey Cake. That's right, you heard that right. Yum, 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 when they stopped by a while back.
That looks absolutely delicious. Plus, things for the kids, the pets, for the whole family. How one local store is providing quarantine packages full of supplies to keep entertained while at home.
And in case you missed the first time, the Container Store helps you get your home desk area organized so you can be as efficient as you can, hopefully making it a bit easier even with all the distractions you might be facing there at home.
And as we mentioned, it's National Puppy Day, so we want you to share pictures of your pets. They can be doing anything. And it's National Puppy Day, but we want to look at all the pets today, right? You got cats at home. We could look at the cats too. Why not?
Yes, and
they're part of it.
You may have reptiles if those are your pets. Yeah. Share them at SA Live KSAT on Facebook and Twitter, and you may see your pet star in the show.
Never miss a story. Watch live or when you want. San Antonio's latest news and weather, streaming free on KSAT TV.
The Academy of Country Music Awards has officially set a new date for its 2020 ceremony.
Officials for the ACM Awards announced it this morning. The new date, Wednesday, September 16th, 8 p.m., more than 5 months after it was originally supposed to take place.
The original air date was April 5th. Keith Urban is still set to host this year's show. We have more information right now on KSAT.com. It's going to be a very crowded fall.
And it'll feel like summer this week. We are going to be seeing more sunshine in the afternoon. In fact, areas like Floresville and Pleasanton starting to see some sun, and we'll warm up to near 80 degrees in the afternoon. Even more sun tomorrow after morning clouds, close to 90. And speaking of the 90s, we'll be in the 90s Wednesday through Friday for the afternoon high temperatures. Feeling a lot like summer. Front will move through Friday night into Saturday morning, bringing a small chance for rain, but really dropping afternoon temperatures into the 70s for the weekend.
What a roller coaster of a week.
I know, it's going to be warm the next few days.
Sarah, Ursula, thank you so much. Instead of Market Square, throw it right across the room.
Right over there.
Hi, SA Live.
All right, well, it's National Puppy Day. We're teaching you some brain games for man's best friend and learning how you can help rescues during these difficult times.
Plus, running out of ideas in the kitchen? We've got an easy recipe you could put on your home menu for brunch. Even the kids will love it.
And need to set up a study station at home for your kids? We've got organizing tips from the experts. SA Live starts right now.
Celebrate San Antonio. Coming to you live from historic Market Square. This is SA Live.
That's adorable.
Yes, we have cued the cuteness. Hello and happy Monday. We hope everyone had a great weekend. And what better way to kick off this week than with something that, of course, makes everybody smiles? Puppies.
Puppies. You got to have the puppies, of course. That's why we're celebrating them today. They're so adorable. And I'm David Elder, in for Mike Osterhage.
I'm Fiona Gorstiza.
And we are broadcasting live from our home base here at KSAT Studios instead of our normal home at Market Square. But it's going to be okay. It's a little different. Yeah. But it's a lot of fun still.
Yeah, and you know, when things get back to normal, we're going to head back over there.
That's right. And now we're going to be celebrating National Puppy Day. And for years, dogs have been used as therapy animals, but helping people through stressful times. So it's certainly an appropriate time to celebrate our furry friends.
You can help brighten someone's day by sharing your pet pics. It doesn't have to be puppies, but just any animal friend that's by your side during these difficult times.
That's right. We want you to post your picture and tag us on social media at SA Live KSAT, and we want to share them later in the show.
With some extra time at home, it's the perfect opportunity to teach your dog some new tricks or brush up on their training.
That's right. A few months ago, we learned some great training tips you could start trying out today.
Well, of course, we love our pets. Hello, sweetie. How are you? Yes, but any owner is going to tell you that getting them to behave like this is a whole lot of work. And Whitley Cheatham, who just said, you know, a well-behaved pet is a lot more fun because you can take them places and have fun with them. Whitley is here with us from Dog Training Elite. She is the owner and lead trainer. Good afternoon.
Hi.
Who is our star of the show right there?
This is Flirt. She's my co-owner. Little guy on the floor is Kit. He's our puppy in training.
Okay. And, so she's very well trained. He is, what, 5 months old?
Yes, sir. He's about 5 months, and we're just getting started. So he's making sure there's no crumbs on the floor.
So, and he's low to the ground, so it's easy for him to do. So you get a new puppy, and, of course, there's going to be the chewing, and there's going to be the potty training. That's the first thing you have to learn how to do, right?
Yeah, that's the first thing I do with any puppy I bring home. I want to get them potty trained so they can have free roam in my house.
Okay.
The name of the game with potty training is going to be consistency. If you stick to a schedule and puppy doesn't have free roam of the house to have those accidents, they'll learn pretty quick not to have accidents in the house.
Okay, and now obviously it's best if somebody is home all the time with them, but if you can't be at home or at night, crate training, and I've always read about that. That's the secret, right?
Yeah, crate training is the safest way to keep your pet at home, and it helps with the potty training because typically a dog doesn't want to potty in their crate.
Okay.
So you can control their access to the house, you can keep them from pottying and having those accidents. Because every time you have an accident, it's going to set you back a little bit because the dog now thinks it's okay to potty in the house.
Wait, okay, yes, okay, yes, you want to play. Hang on 1 second. Okay, now this is something that we would train also is not to jump. But
yes,
the
sir.
Other thing that you want them to do, the command to come.
Right. And so it's a safety thing, it's a respect thing. You can't do anything with your dog if they won't come when called. So that's the next thing I do after we've taught them some potty training and kind of some basic rules of the house. Kit, come. Hey.
And you're kind of forcing the issue there, but that's the whole thing is to teach them to come to you and use the leash for that,
boy.
Right?
Right, and so I'm not dragging him to me, but I am giving him help when he doesn't get it. Another thing you can do is step back from your dog to encourage them to come back to you. Kit. Mm-hmm.
And it's a little tough in the studio
with
cameras and all sorts of weird smells
yeah.
on the floor too.
So
and you're also
you
giving
them
treats, and that's the whole reward thing, right? Because they got to
yep.
do it for come here,
Kit.
Come here, come there.
Good boy.
And one word commands. you know,
I like
say,
one word
come
commands.
Here, poochie, pooka, poochie, or something like, just like, come, right?
Right. I like one word, one syllable commands, because that's all the dog hears. If it's come here, all they're really hearing is come.
And the other one is, hello, yes, we'll get you another one if you, you obey. Stay.
Yes, sir. And so I like to teach stay in the presence of sit. So when I teach a puppy to sit, get, we'll see if he'll do it with all the distraction going on. Good boy. It starts with just sit for 1 second. Uh-uh.
Okay.
And then take a step back. Good.
And like us learning even with muscle memory, it's them. You do it over and over again enough and they're going to catch on. But you don't want to do it, you don't want to overwhelm them, right?
Right. So with the puppy this age, we're maybe working 5-7 minutes tops at a time. And we'll do that several times throughout the day. I like to do about 20 minutes total per day.
Okay, well thank you very much. This has been fascinating. And if you would like more information on Dog Training Elite, go to our website, SALive.com, and click on the As Seen on SA Live tab. You did good too. Yes, and you look handsome in the outfit.
Well, Dog Training Elite has a few more brain games for your pup. How about a guessing game? Using a cupcake baking sheet, hide some dog food or a treat in one pocket, and then cover them with some tennis balls. Your dog has to figure out which one has the treat.
That dog is so intense. That dog is intense, man. You could also play hide and seek with some tasty goodies. Place treats in a small box and see if your dog can find it and get the treats. But be sure to use a box you don't mind tearing up, because dogs don't get crazy, okay? And these are fun ways that you and your dog can play and learn together, and all these things are things you can find around the house.
Dog Training Elite is working on launching virtual training so they can still work one-on-one with you and your pups during social distancing. To learn more about Dog Training Elite, just head to our website, salive.com, and click on the As Seen on SA Live tab. Well, he can always sweeten our day by letting us know how he's doing.
That's right, and it's time to check in with our Mike Osterhage at home and see what he's doing. There he is, always got his puppy with him.
Oh, look at that, in honor of National Puppy Day,
yes.
Mike.
There he is. You've seen Max before. He's been on the show a couple of times. And have you all seen the meme that's going around where it says, you know, with a lot of folks at home now 24/7, dogs are just as happy as can be because their people are at home and cats are like, oh, get them out of here. Get me out of here. So, yes, but Max is enjoying having everybody at home, aren't you, Max? And somebody just delivered some food. And so he got all kind of riled up there. And Max has also been learning some tricks, too. I've been teaching him how to speak. Yes, so Max, what's on the top of this house? Roof, roof. Very good. What's on the side of that tree? Bark, bark. Very good.
You've been working on that one, Mike. Mike knew this was coming all weekend, and he's been like practicing these jokes.
There you are. Okay. Like it kind of froze there for a bit. Okay. Well, what else? What else are you doing today, Mike?
Pardon me.
You know what?
You got your hands full.
Mike, we're going to let you do your thing. Happy National Puppy Day. You got your hands full with your dog jokes. He's just doing a lot over there.
He was sitting there waiting to do that.
He is. He had those things ready to go. Him in that little book of knowledge. Probably has a little joke book off to the side as well.
Continuing to file it away. Well, how about a tasty breakfast to sweeten your day?
That's right. Whiskey Cake stopped by a few months ago and shared a mouthwatering cinnamon roll pancake recipe. All right,
so
cinnamon
good.
Rolls in a pancake, okay? And showed off some of their brunch items. Check it out.
One brunch, three juice recipes, and a lot of flavor. Mary Lou Davis from Whiskey Cake Kitchen and Bar is here to give us the scoop on how she does it. And she's
already doing it right now.
Scooping up some goodness now.
You are making what? What are we starting?
I am making you our cinnamon roll pancakes.
Oh,
and this is going to be a really good treat because, first of all, who doesn't love cinnamon rolls?
Right.
And second of all, we put it inside of our new pancakes. And what makes our pancakes different is we actually have a mesquite flour that we use that is going to be the mesquite pods from the mesquite tree, and we grind them up and incorporate them into our flour. That way it goes back to our wood fire grill, you know, everything smoky. We just tried to put a little quirk on things.
Does that then add a different flavor to it?
It does. You can taste a little bit of a smoky flavor, and if you look at the batter, it's got kind of like a yellowy type of hue to it.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And that's just because of the mesquite flour that we're using.
Okay. So, and then you're going to be adding the cinnamon roll portion to it?
Oh, yeah. You guys are going to help me with that one.
Okay. So while that's going for a little bit, let's take a look at all the other yum-yum on the table.
Yeah.
Okay. All the good things that we have going on. First one in your hand is going to be our BLT. It's our play of a BLT, obviously, but we're going to add our egg onto it. It is going to be with fried green tomatoes as well on a brioche bun.
Ooh, that sounds really good. Next over here.
The next one that you have is going to be our pork, egg, and grits. And so these are the grits that we're making at least every other day.
Yeah.
And they are going to be corn and poblano jack grits. It is going to be with our pork that is going to have a sorghum rye glaze on top of it, and a beautiful sunny side up egg. Uh-huh. Next, you guys are going to have our Monte Cristo French toast, which you have already taken a nice little bite out of it.
I sure did.
I hope you enjoyed it.
But what's in it? It's what's in it that makes it so amazing.
Exactly. So inside of it is going to be our Duroc ham, which is going to be a sweeter type of ham. It's also going to have our mac and cheese base inside of it that we make in-house, and it's going to be nice and ooey and gooey and creamy, so when you're eating it, you're just getting all of those good flavors together.
So just the cheesy portion of the mac and cheese is in there, right?
Just the cheesy, the mac itself. So now that we've already flipped over our pancakes, we're just going to brush it with the cinnamon glaze, and the residual heat from the pancakes should just make that glaze permeate all the way through.
What do you make the cinnamon glaze out of?
We make the cinnamon glaze out of corn syrup. We have cinnamon. That's pretty much it.
Okay.
If you wanted to experiment
at home with something like that, you could just corn syrup and dump a bunch of cinnamon in it?
Uh-huh, and then just like heat it up so that it's all nice and incorporated, mix it all nice and around, that way you're getting this beautiful color. It's gonna have actually a little bit of brown sugar as well.
Oh, yes.
Oh, the close-up view of that
right?
is just heavenly.
So glossy.
I mean, it almost looks like you're just smearing it with Nutella.
I could. You could definitely do that one at your house as well.
And while we're finishing these up, you also have some pressed juices, too?
Indeed. All right. Next to us, so we don't just have the wonderful 500 varieties of whiskey. We actually have our house squeezed juice drinks. We are squeezing these juices every single day. This one right here is actually my favorite, probably because it's my favorite color. This is our Incredible Hulk. It is going to be made with cucumber juice, basil, mint, lemon juice. All of the good stuff. Mm-hmm. And then this one right here is going to be our Jessica Wabbit. Oh,
okay. That's really refreshing.
Isn't it?
Yeah,
I love it.
That's very refreshing.
And the great thing is we have such a wide variety of juices. Like our Jessica Wabbit is going to be really earthy. That one is going to be really refreshing. We have another juice, our guava. It is going to be very just sweet and straightforward. And I love all of our juices. So now we're getting to the finishing touches. We're going to pick up each pancake, slide it right on top.
That looks. Oh, we're gonna stack them.
Oh, yeah. You have to stack.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Whipped cream?
Mm-hmm. Wait, the whipped cream goes last. Okay, so make your design, whichever design that you want.
It's gone.
That works.
I put the glaze on it.
It's the everything.
All right, go ahead and put some syrup on it.
You really
want this whipped
cream.
You're
really
like, I'm ready.
Finish with the whipped cream.
Okay, now your whipped cream.
Now the whipped cream, and then
our house spice pecans.
House spice pecans. Boom! All right.
Yes.
Thank you so much. For more information on whiskey cake, just head to our website, salive.com, and click on the As Seen on SA Live tab.
I am totally blown away by that. That looks crazy. Okay, the Whiskey Cake Dining Room is closed right now, but you can still order to go. They're also offering quarantine kits. Their content changes daily, and there's limited availability. We have a link to their website on salive.com. Just click on the As Seen on SA Live tab.
I'm so hungry.
I know, me too. All right, still ahead on SA Live. Things for the kids, the pets, and for the whole family. A local store is providing quarantine packages full of supplies to keep entertained guests at home.
But first, adoptions have been brought to a near standstill. How one local dog rescue is coping with social distancing and how you can help from the comfort of your own home. That's next on SA Live. In honor of National Puppy Day, earlier we asked you to share your pet pictures. This is from Rosie Marie, and this is Pijo, right?
Yeah, Pijo.
Pijo and Lucy. Look at them all snuggled up.
Aww. That's really cute.
Okay. Well, they're not practicing social distancing, but social distancing has taken its toll on many different things, including animal rescues.
That's correct. The Texas Chihuahua Rescue tells us how adoptions have been brought to a virtual standstill and how the big online event that they're hoping can turn things around might work for them. Check it out.
So this is Puppers. Puppers is a little mix. We're not really sure of what. He is about 4 months old. He's super playful and silly. He gets along with everybody. He was found as a stray here in San Antonio. So most of our dogs go to Canada. We got to the point where about 75% of our adoptions were in Canada. All the Canadian borders are closed to US residents and anyone trying to cross the border back and forth, so the adopters included cannot come in and even pick up their dogs. So now not only do we have dogs that were technically adopted, but now here in limbo, so they have to stay here and wait until the borders open. But then also a lot of our adoptions are kind of at a standstill. We are still doing local adoptions. So we're hoping that our Texas people come out in droves to foster and adopt from Texas Chihuahua Rescue, because the dogs at the ranch and in the you know, in our foster homes that are here that normally go to Canada, if we can't move the dogs to their adopters, then we can't fill the ranch with more dogs and save more lives. And this is happening to a lot of rescues, not just Texas Chihuahua Rescue. So the shelters are getting starting to be very, very full. Some of the shelters are shutting down. And then we have little Mia, who is actually found in Harlingen area in South Texas. And Mia's 8 months old. I would say 8 to 9 months old. She's a really, really sweet little girl. She loves everybody. She's very pouncy and bouncy and has a lot of fun. So, but we have a ton of dogs for adoption. So I think we are up to close to 52 dogs right now available for adoption. March 26th, and it's 24 hours. We're calling it You Can't Keep a Good Dog Down, because although this is all going on and it's very crazy in human world, the dogs are still, they think every day is the same. They want to be fed and loved and taken care of and rescued. So it's from midnight till midnight, and so we will be doing an online all fundraiser. So anybody could participate in it. We'll be showing videos and stories, before and after photos. You'll kind of get a look into our everyday life there. And so you'll see on our website, texaschihuahuarescue.org, and on our Facebook and our Instagram, you'll see all the details and fun pictures all day long on March 26th. Both of these dogs are still pretty young and would do great with kids and families. They're pretty active. They get along with other dogs. So really anywhere that would be willing to take them for a walk once in a while, get out of the house, have kids to play with, or a family that's willing to let them spend some of this energy. But both of them are also super cuddly and sweet too. Donations, of course, and adoptions are low. People are just not coming out. And although we do understand completely, it's really important for the dogs. The dogs don't understand what's going on, and they just want to find a good home. So the good thing is, while everybody's home, they should foster a puppy.
And straight ahead on the flip side of the break, everything for families staying home. What a local store is offering in quarantine care packages. Welcome back to SA Live. Well, small businesses are having to rethink how they can stay open and be relevant to customers.
That's right. We talked to a local shop, Felice Modern, to see what they are doing in this time and what they have going on for National Puppy Day. Check it out.
I'm Ginger Diaz, owner of Feliz Modern, a local gift shop that focuses on local art and gifts, and gifts from around the world. And we have two shops, one in Olmos Park and one at the Pearl. And now that everything is closed for a while, our main shop is on felizmodern.com, where you can find all of our items and choose between free curbside delivery or free shipping. Today I'm going to talk about some doggy items since it's puppy day. Our very popular dog poncho, and we have it in sizes from extra, extra small through extra, extra large. We also have the same sizes for our doggy guayaberas that are made in Mexico and feel like the real thing. We also, a lot of people use these human bandanas for their dogs as well, and they'll take it and put it around the dog's neck like that. We also have these fun Girona doggy toys. And speaking of doggy day, we have these dog puzzles that are great for kids that are home from school right now. They're small little puzzles of different dogs that keep kids busy while they're at home. And we also have little stamp kits that they can make different cards and gifts out of, or art. Kids and adults also love these embroidery kits. This is made by local duo Nin and Needles, and they come with everything you need, with including the string. Other items that we have when you're stuck at home for who knows how long, we have these florist puzzles. They're different beautiful florists from around the world. And for the adults who are also stuck at home, there's the gin game, which is great for parties of two, since you don't want to have a lot of people in your home right now. And we have really fun coloring books that adults and kids love. There's the Friends coloring book, which is, of course, always popular. This is a popular coloring book that we carry called The Office, and it has all your favorite characters from the TV show. And we have a puzzle of one of our favorite artists, Frida Kahlo. We also have coloring books that feature famous artists as well, with some inspirational sayings, like from Andy Warhol. We have reusable sticker scenes. So this folds out, and then you use these stickers to create different scenes and stories. Kids love these stacking markers. Each one comes often as a different color, so they can make a whole piece of art from one pen. These are fun table games at the dinner table. After dinner, you could pull out a slip of paper and see who's the biggest movie buff or music buff. This one's the movie and music's edition, and we have other editions as well. This is a popular coffee table game that you just leave sitting out, and then whoever's sitting around can play tic-tac-toe. And on our website, FelizModern.com, we've collected four different quarantine kits that you can build care packages from. We have one for grown-ups, for teens, for kids, and for pets. I know we're all very stressed out with COVID and figuring out what to do in this new landscape. And I know a lot of my small business friends are struggling very hard as we are as well to keep all of their employees and to keep their business surviving past the quarantine. So I just really thank everybody who's been going online to our website and shopping online or to our friends' websites or ordering to go from restaurants. It means the world to the small businesses, and hopefully we have a lot of small businesses survive.
And next, it's a fun way to learn about the wilderness. An animal adventurer tells us how you can add his show to your kids at home and how they can watch it, all of his lessons. But first, here's a little of what you missed on last week's Texas Eats.
Frank, how's it going, man?
It's going, bud. How are you?
I'm doing great. You got all kinds of food. Ordering in advance, of course.
Give us a call. We'll get your order ready. Being a small businessman, I'm not the richest man in the world, but I do have some money put away for my employees so that I don't have to lay anybody off. Don't take this as being beat. We haven't been beat. We just, you know, get stronger. Help out your neighbors. You know, whatever you can do to benefit somebody, you know, it's going to come back to you. So just stay strong. Stay strong.
Look at that. So is it still the full menu, guys?
Full menu, yeah. I just had these all done. I've got my full menu out. I'm not going to cut my menu. We have a small menu, so I don't have to cut anything. Just fresh.
Wow.
Control our ordering and make sure we stay on point.
Everything is bigger in Texas, right? So if you're looking to get your little ones up close with animals without leaving the house, of course, Coyote Peterson can help with just with that.
Jen Tobias Drusky caught up with him about his educational series.
Up close with wild animals. Wait, let me paint a better picture for you. How about jumping into murky water to catch an alligator snapping turtle? Who does that? Coyote Peterson, animal expert and adventurer. That's who. His YouTube channel, Brave Wilderness, has over 15 million subscribers. Such a pleasure to chat with you today about your new adventure, Coyote. How are you?
I'm fantastic, Jen. Thanks for having me on the show.
Well, first of all, my kids are proud to say that they're part of the Coyote Pack.
That is very exciting. Please tell them thank you for being such brave members of the pack. And everybody who watches our content is considered a member of the Coyote Pack. If we're getting kids of all ages, 3 to 93, excited about animals, we're doing the right job.
Because I know that you get up close, you're not scared at all. To get up close with these animals, most people would say, he's crazy. How can you get so close? Where does it come from? You're obviously very passionate.
Well, what's amazing is it's snapping turtles, and I'm very excited for everybody there in Texas because our premiere episode, a large part of it actually takes place in Cleveland, Texas, where I caught the largest alligator snapping turtle I think that has ever been featured on camera, an absolute giant. This thing is a living dinosaur. You know, they say everything is bigger in Texas, and that is definitely the case. But it was snapping turtles that started my love for this journey that became teaching the world about bizarre creatures. Most people don't recognize or realize what a snapping turtle is, whether it's a common snapping turtle or an alligator snapping turtle, but both of these animals deserve their time in front of the spotlight.
I did get a sneak peek, and I did get to learn a little bit more about them thanks to you, so thank you for all you do. If it's okay with you, I had my daughter record a question. If you want to listen for it, she's going to ask it.
Hi, Katie. I'm your biggest fan. I have a bunch of pets. I want to ask you a question. How furry is a koala?
Thank you for the wonderful question, Julia. Koalas are incredibly soft, but here's something you probably didn't know. They smell like cheese. They may be adorable, but they are not the best smelling marsupial on the face of the planet. The males actually have this little scent gland on their chest that they will like rub up on the bark of trees. A koala is one of the stinkier creatures that you can ever work with, but what they have in sync, they definitely balance out with their adorable nature.
I did not know that. Well, thanks for sharing. And what is is the scariest encounter that you've ever had?
Probably one with grizzly bears on the side of a river in Alaska. Mm-hmm. I was actually put into that same scenario that you saw in that film, The Revenant, with Leonardo DiCaprio. A mother bear, her three cubs, 100 yards in closing, and fortunately we were able to scare the bears off and were not attacked. But it was without question the scariest animal encounter I've ever had, because if a mother bear decides she's going to defend her cubs, trust me, you're not going to be able to get away.
Wow, I don't know how you do that. Speaking of scary, I know you've been bit, you've been stung. My son Rai Rai has a question for you.
Hello, Coyote Houston. My name is Rai Rai. What animal bite was the most painful?
I would only say about 2% of the content we've produced is the bite and sting content, where I'm intentionally bitten or stung by something to show you the effects of the bite or the venom. Obviously, this is a content that people have found very fascinating. It still has quite the educational spin on it. But when it comes to the most painful bite I've ever taken, it was actually an accidental bite from the only venomous lizard in the United States, which is called the Gila monster. And that simply happened by getting a camera too close. It latched onto my thumb. And let's just say that was the most painful day I've ever had to endure.
My goodness. Okay. Well, we love going along on your adventures. Let's talk about your new show on Animal Planet. So Coyote Peterson, Brave the Wild.
This show is just fun, right? So if you've seen the YouTube content, you know it's fast-paced. We get you into the environment. We get you up close with the animals. But Brave the Wild is a longer form narrative, right? We're telling 30-minute to hour-long episodes, and there's so many animals packed into each and every single episode, right? 79 animals featured within the first season, and every single adventure feels like I'm literally grabbing you by the hand, taking you with me off into the wilderness, and you never know what's going to happen next. So when I say it's fun, I promise it's going to deliver for kids of all ages. Doesn't matter if you're 3 years old, or you're an adult, or you're 93 years old, this is the show for you if you love animals and adventure.
Thank you, Coyote, for being such an inspiration to everyone, all the animal lovers like myself, and I hope you have a great day. Thank you.
Thanks, Jen.
All right, next on SA Live, get your home workspace in order with tips from the pros at the Container Store.
And earlier, we asked you to share your pet pics on this National Puppy Day. Let's see. Charissa says Gabby and Roxy waiting on a treat. Oh, they're waiting. Look, they're really cute.
So
that looks
good.
Like Max. Did Max go to another house?
And Anne sends this photo of her precious fur baby smiling big.
That's adorable.
And speaking of Puppy Day, here's a dog rescue that needs your help.
Our motto is rescue on. So adoptions are down, which means risk of euthanasia is up. And so we're trying to take in as many dogs as we can to help with this current crisis. And we need foster homes for that. And our foster homes are at capacity. Everybody's got 1 to 2 foster dogs right now. So we're always needing more fosters. So we have an application on our website. There's a separate application for fosters and another one for adopters. And they just need to complete that form.
Welcome back to SA Live. Well, school is back in session for many kids. Well, sort of, right? Students are resuming online sessions, and some parents are picking up study packets from school. A few months ago, we had some experts come in, give us some tips on turning a desk from a homework station into something that you can actually use at home, right? Check it out.
It's very important to stay organized as the school year is underway, and I could definitely use some help as a mom of two, and Anthony with the Container Store is here to help me. You have a homework station for us, a family command center.
Exactly.
We're starting here. Tell me what
so
we have.
Here is our homework desk. This is an ideal solution with everything that you would need to stay organized and on target throughout the year. A couple of helpful tips. Try and keep your work surface clear and open. It's much more conducive to getting the homework done if you have room and space to do it. I love the great pop-in post-it note container, soccer ball. One fun thing is having a calendar and funds specific sticky notes. If you have a special event coming up, dinner with friends, sporting event, and kids love it to do this as well, you'll help
help get them started, being organized. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Put your stickers on your gymnastics practice days and all that good stuff.
If your Friday is pizza day, put the little sticker on there, put them back on the wall. Now, if you don't have a whole wall for a homework station,
look at that.
The Container Store shows us great three-tier rolling cart. You can have this filed away in an entryway closet, pull it out, and it's a portable homework station.
So
when
no
it's done, push it back. No excuses.
Kids,
yep.
No excuses.
It's going to stay organized, and that homework's getting done.
And it gets put away.
And back away. Exactly.
Back to being neat. So when I get home for the day, what we call it, the family drop zone, but you have a good way to stay organized.
Family command center. So this can be the heart of the home. Everything has a place for shoes, lunch bags, backpacks, coats, water bottles. And don't forget to add a calendar, because even though you may have one in other areas of the home, since this is one of the first and last things that everyone sees in the home, they'll know any important events that are going on for that day.
Perfect.
Now, if you need a more streamlined solution for your family command center, we have a great mesh three-section.
Magnets, too.
With magnets. Yeah, you can personalize it with pictures. Or we have the great stackable basket solution at the Container Store, where everyone can have their own color, no hunting in the morning.
So hooks, calendar, and no excuses if you don't have the space. You have other options, right, to stay organized.
Exactly.
Looking for things to keep us occupied at home during this tough time, how about getting a virtual braces consultation? Our friends at Celebrate Dental and Braces are hooking you up with a revolutionary new way to get a consultation without leaving your home. Now, we recorded this segment with Dr. Ferguson last month. Check it out. Thank you so much for being here. So it all starts with a selfie, right?
Yeah, I mean, that's what makes it so easy, Fiona. I think a lot of times patients, a lot of people want to know, hey, how long would it take for me to straighten my teeth and how much would it cost? And sometimes, you know, what prevents them from finding that information out is just the inconvenience of having to take off work, get out of school, get the kids out of school and bring them into the orthodontist to find that information out. And that's why we're really excited. You know, we came up with a website, mysmileselfie.com. And your viewers can go there right now, and all they have to do is take a couple pictures with their cell phone. There's a little video, it'll show them exactly how to do it. They take a couple pictures with their cell phone. It'll actually come to me or one of my partner orthodontists, and we're able to send them a consultation that will tell them how long it would take and how much it would cost to get that smile they've always wanted.
Now, it says right there, get an instant estimate on braces. So I'm assuming that quote will come pretty quickly, right?
Well, you know, I got to get done with with this spot right now.
Of course. You know, they're coming in right now.
Yeah, I hope so. You know, it takes about 24 hours to get a custom quote back. Okay. And that's the reason it takes that is because each one is done specifically for that person,
right, which is great. I mean, to be, you know, that tailored to that individual and their needs. Now, once you have your quote, can you visit any Celebrate Dental location?
Absolutely. So here in San Antonio, we have 6 locations spread throughout the city. You know, one of the missions of Celebrate Dental is to really be convenient. So yeah, any office in town.
Okay, and how many places around town?
6 locations, kind of spread all around the city. If you go to CelebrateDental.com, you can see where those are.
And hours are pretty great as far as for folks who have 9-to-5 jobs, right?
Absolutely. You know, you can take selfies anytime you want and send them in, but if you're coming into the office, that's what we love is we're able to offer hours from 8 to 7 every single weekday, and we're also open every Saturday. So every evening, every Saturday, we're there.
And I love that. Evenings and Saturdays, as you've mentioned, which is great for not only just working adults, but adults with kids, okay, which, you know, gives all that flexibility, and insurance can also help with the cost, right?
Absolutely. Insurance is always going to help. We accept all PPO insurances. We accept Medicaid. We accept Medicare. And really, there's a lot of patients who come in thinking that if they don't have insurance, that it's not going to be affordable. And it's just not true. We have our own in-house discount plan for a small monthly fee of $10. Patients can sign up and get all of the maximum discounts. There's no waiting periods, no maximums, no deductibles, so they can also go to the website and learn more there.
Oh my gosh, that's great, great to know. So specials going on right now for folks watching. There it is on your screen, right?
Yeah, exactly. You know, for the patients that call right now or go to mysmileselfie.com, they'll get a free consultation. We'll send them a price estimate and how long it would take. And anybody who mentions this ad can also get braces for $99 a month. There's no credit check and no down payment.
All right, there is the information on your screen. Just call 210-201-1696. That's 210-201-1696. Or just head to mysmileselfie.com. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Fiona.
Well, you can still take care of yourself while you practice social distancing. Again, just send a few selfies to mysmileselfie.com and the orthodontist will tell you how long it will take and how much it will cost at Celebrate Dental and Braces, all from the safety of your own home. All right, tomorrow on SA Live, food you can make at home that's nutritious and delicious. Jess Romeo has great ways to include veggies in your home-cooked meals. And for those of you who don't want to cook, find out about a great food delivery option. They deliver other things too, and you won't have to leave your house for a delicious meal. That's all tomorrow at 1 on SA Live.
All right, earlier we asked you to send in pictures of your puppies on National Puppy Day, and we have some great pictures that have come in. Crystal Hernandez shared this one. My Winston adopted my baby. My chemo buddy goes with me everywhere. That's
aww,
adorable.
Crystal, we are so glad you have that support.
Look at that cute little dog right there. It has like a little, the heart get added on from her. That's adorable.
And Janelle sends this for her baby, Chewy. Chewy, I get why. His name Chewy, looks like Chewbacca.
Oh, that one's hiding. All right, Carissa says, Maggie likes to build pillow forts. Look at that.
Aww.
That looks comfortable. That's how you snuggle in the quarantine right there.
That's really comfy. Yvette sends this picture of her pet.
Looks like it's staring out the window.
Yes.
Of course, that's what dogs gotta do.
Wondering why am I not out?
Mallory Hibbert shares these two pictures. Looks like a little French bulldog or a Boston Terrier and some kind of Cocker Spaniel of some sort. That's really adorable.
Yeah, we need some of this great energy to take us out.
Yeah, thanks for watching.